Ever heard of the dinosaur wars? No, the term doesn't refer to T-Rexes duking it out with stegosauruses. Instead, it refers to the way a couple of scientists became downright nasty in their pursuit of fame, fortune, and dinosaur bones. Meet Othniel Marsh and Edward Cope. These two 19th century paleontologists were some of the most successful and esteemed dinosaur hunters of their day. They wowed the public with their discoveries and attracted a lot of research money in the process. In the early days, their competition was beneficial to science. Each drove the other to work hard, and each was quick to point out if the other had made a mistake. But over time, the feelings between them grew less and less friendly. And by 1890, the competition had literally become destructive. Their teams began throwing stones at one another when digging in the same territory. Both sides allegedly destroyed important sites with dynamite just to keep them out of the reach of the other, burying or obliterating a still unknown number of priceless specimens in the process. This rivalry, which had once pushed these men to advance science, now drove them to undermine it. Here's where their story can teach us an economics lesson. Under what circumstances does competition, a vital force for innovation and progress, actually become destructive? The answer is that competition becomes destructive when people start using fraud or force to outcompete their rivals. By literally destroying the competition's work, an economist would say that each of these men was attempting to artificially contrive exclusivity. In other words, they were trying to get an unfair advantage. In today's economy, big businesses rarely dynamite one another, but they don't have to, because they can use force provided by the government instead. Economists refer to the profits gained from exclusivity as rents, so the attempt to use government power to get exclusive benefits has been dubbed rent-seeking. Rent-seeking is probably the most important economic term that most people have never heard of. It's everywhere in our economy today. Whenever big corporations and other special interests ask a government for special favors, they're rent-seeking. They do this because government can offer them a number of special privileges. Some firms, like Goldman Sachs, Citigroup, and GM, have obtained the privilege of a federal bailout. Others, like major agribusinesses, are privileged with federal farm subsidies. And still others, like major Hollywood production companies, are privileged through favorable state and local tax laws. There have now been hundreds of studies of rent-seeking and the economics of special privilege. These studies find that whatever its guise, rent-seeking is an enormously destructive force. It wastes resources, it slows the entrepreneurial process, and it locks in inefficient technologies. Beyond this, though, it's fundamentally unfair. It allows some to succeed based not on their ability to please customers, but on their ability to work the political system. Like the dinosaur wars, rent-seeking is an ugly corruption of fair competition and an impediment to progress.